What's up, guys? Mark from Disney here. Huh? No, it's out. Destiny Cargo. So, I wanted to make a video. So I have a list of videos I have to make. And like every time I can't come up with an original video, I go back to that list to try to knock out all the videos, right? And one of the videos I had on my list, eBay just made a change, so which affects that video. So that's why I'm doing the video now. So the video is about, you can say hi.
Hey guys.
Yeah, Jack is here. So the video is about completing sales outside of eBay in order to make more money.
Oh, the final value fee thing?
Yeah,
I saw that today.
So, because I used to do that, right? So I'll explain what scenario usually that came up with me. It comes up a couple times a month, actually. So let me explain what it is and then we'll get to it. So a couple times a month, I would have like an item that someone wants to buy like 10 or 20 of, right? Some of those items that I could think of off the top of my head are like, I still have it. Some white folding plastic tables. I've had people that want to buy like 20 or 30 of them. Folding chairs, I've had that. I've had the fucking, the metal shelf that I spoke about a couple of times. So once in a while you'll have someone message you and be like, hey, I want to buy a lot of this item, can I get a discount? So I usually use that opportunity to be like, hey, I can give you a 5% discount, but I have to figure some stuff out. So give me a call, send me a number, let's talk and let's figure out like how we can do this. And what I would do is that I would give them the price minus 5% if they pay me via PayPal. Now what that does, it gets rid of the 9% eBay fee and they also get a discount, so they feel good about it. And I make more money because although I'm not getting 5%, I'm saving 9%. So I actually make 4% more. And it's usually a big order, right? So you make, I don't know, 4% more on like $500, right? Which is 20 bucks extra. So it works out. So I've been meaning to do this video about using that to make some extra money. The fuck?
What happened to you?
I got bitten by something.
When?
I'm allergic to stuff.
Holy shit!
Jesus Christ! Sorry, no, Carlos just came downstairs and his face is red. And he, what the fuck? Okay, sorry, what was I saying? Yeah, so I was meant to make this video to give you guys some little tricks on how to make some extra money. But then today I saw an email from eBay. You saw that email also,
yeah.
Right? So basically, anytime eBay suspects, and I'll put a link to the eBay article in the description. Anytime eBay suspects that you completed a sale outside of eBay, they can charge you for the final fees.
Yeah, and I think it's not even when they suspect that you completed a sale, it's when they suspect that you shared contact information. It doesn't even,
right.
Implies that you did that to complete a sale, but if there's any evidence in message history, you get charged a final value fee for the item, even though.
Yeah, even though they don't have concrete proof that it sells.
Yeah.
Now, me personally, I'm still gonna continue doing this shit, right? Unless eBay threatens to close my account. Like I've gone through, as I said, I'm sort of a savage. I like to make extra money. If eBay catch me, they'll charge me the final fee and whatever, right? Like I'll deal with that. Or if I do it and I get caught, I will make a video about it and let you guys know what the result is. So I would still, and I personally would still do it. But have you ever completed a sale outside of eBay?
No, I usually don't.
Yeah, you just want as quick as possible.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, I know you can work around it by like, people just send a photo and the photo has their like email address, that kind of thing. Cause eBay, like if you guys have noticed, whenever you share a message, if you put an email address in the message won't send and it'll tell you to remove the email address.
Right.
So you have to do some like workarounds with text and at symbols and that kind of thing.
Or another thing you could do is like, this is another thing that I've done in the past. because I was afraid of getting caught also. So if you complete a sale, you can request their contact information from eBay, right? So if you get that request, you can tell them like, hey, buy one.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Through, and then I'll contact you and we'll figure out what discount I can give you, and then you can buy more. So in that way, eBay doesn't really, you don't have to share the contact information through the messages. You do process an order through eBay. And I used to do that even before this thing because I was afraid of being caught, mm-hmm. right? So now that I saw this email, I figured I could do the video.
Yeah, as long as eBay gets a cut at some point there, because they have a, it's like, I'm usually on the receiving end of that where I'll get an email that's like, hey, the buyer initiated our like swap for contact information request. And since they submitted this in the past, like they had a sale with you in the previous X amount of days, we supplied them with your contact information. This is just a notification to let you know.
Right. So if you process a sale, you could also get the contact information. So that's one way you could try to get around it. That's something I used to do all the time, but because this change happened with last night,
I got
the email yesterday.
Night, yeah.
So because this happened yesterday, I don't know, like I haven't tested that to see if it'll work, but that's something that I personally would do. Like every time I get to, and again, I have like one or two people here that do some of the work for me. I have one girl that does my customer service. She doesn't work out of here. She actually lives in the US, but whatever. But so anytime something like that comes up, like I use that opportunity to make extra money, but that's just me personally. But anyway, thanks for your time, guys. Subscribe, love you.
I didn't
curse in this video, so that's, or did I?
Monetization.
No, I might have cursed when I saw Carlos.
Oh yes.
Anyway, have a good one, guys. The half-naked dropshipper has allergic reactions, so you might wear some clothes. Anyway, subscribe. I'm trying to get to 10,000 subscribers, and look in the description for the free stuff, free trading, and free group and stuff. Later. How do I get to turn this off? How do you-